Welcome to Smart Syllabus, dear students. So as you know, already we are in your SSLC final exam preparation crash course. So in this crash course, students learn every day 100% question which is going to appear in your final examination. So you have to watch all the videos of this series to score better in your final examination. The links of the remaining all videos is in the description. You can check from there. And if you want to get the similar videos even in the future, then you have to subscribe the channel and press the bell icon. Today we learn one more 100% question, student. So let's start now. As you know, students, we are only dealing with the topic called probability. So from previous three videos, we are in this topic now. So we are learning all the important parts which are very important for the examination point of view under this topic, that is probability. So the important parts are, as you know, students, in the previous video we discussed about a dice. So whenever a dice is thrown once, dice is thrown twice, how to calculate such sums only we discussed. And apart from that, in the third video we discussed about a coin, tossing a coin once and tossing a coin twice, always two coins at a time. So how to calculate probability of the coin, even that we calculated in the previous video. So today in this video we are going to focus on this, students, that is about cards. In this video, students, we are going to discuss in depth related to the cards, and of course it's all many sums related to cards. So be with the video till the end, like the video and share these videos with your friends. Okay, let's continue now. So today, before diving deep into the sums related to the cards, first we'll get some brief knowledge about the cards now. So as you can see in the picture, students, these are the cards about that we are going to study. Okay, first let's count how many cards are there in one set. So as you can see, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. So like that, 4 rows are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 into 13, it's 52. In the sense, in a set of cards, totally 52 cards are present always. Now, out of those 52 cards, now again, if we categorize these 13 plus these 13, these are black color cards. It means 13 plus 13, it's 26. So 26 are black color cards. Now again, as you can see here, these are 13 and again these are 13. So 13 plus 13, these are red color cards. So 26 are red color cards. So first divide like this. These are black color cards, these are red color cards. Now again, division if you do, the first 13 cards, as you can see the shape here. Now this shape is called club. So these all are club cards. So how many club cards are there? 13. So 13 club cards. As you can see this shape, now this is like a leaf, right? So this is called spade. So 13 are spade. Similarly, as you can see, this is a heart shape. So these are heart cards. So 13 are heart cards. And the last one is, as you can see, this is a diamond. So there are 13 diamond cards. So 13 plus 13, 26. These are black color cards. 13 plus 13, 26. These are red color cards and these are black color cards. So totally this comes to, total comes to 52 cards are there, right? Now in the set of 13 cards, there is a card called A. A means it is 1, but 2 it is also known as ace card. So in a set of 52 cards, if it is asked how many ace cards are there, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 ace cards are there. Out of that, 2 are black ace cards, 2 are red ace cards. Again, out of that, under the club section there is only 1 ace card, under spade section only 1, heart section only 1, and diamond section only 1 ace card is there, right? Okay, now as you can see here, they're called face cards. So how many face cards are there? 1, 2, 3. So in every set of 13, 3 face cards are there. In the sense, under the black cards, how many face cards are there? 1, 2, 3, four, five, six face cards are there. Under the red section, how many face cards are there? As you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six face cards are there. In total, out of 52 cards, how many face cards are there? If it is asked, you can say 6 plus 6, totally 12 face cards are there. I think it is clear enough, right? So these are all important things you must know, students, before solving a particular sum. Now again, in face cards, three types of face cards. One is called Joker, another one is called Queen, and the third one is called King. Now just go on answering few questions now. Okay, out of 52 sets, how many black king cards? 1 and 2. So 2 are there. Next question. Out of 52 cards, how many queen cards are there? So it is not mentioned any color, right? So how many queen cards? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 queen cards are there. Okay, next. Out of 52 cards, how many red jacks are there? Jack in the sense choker. So it is 1, 2. So 2 jacks are there under the red section. So like this, students, whatever question it is asked, if we are able to identify the number of the cards out of 52, the sums related to cards is just very, very easy. So understand this part first thoroughly, right? Okay, last one question now. How many spade cards are there? 13. How many heart cards are there? 13. How many black cards with 6 are there? You can see only 2. How many black jacks are there? 2. How many heart cards are there? 13. How many red kings are there? Only 2. How many red aces are there? Only 2. So like this, any question if it is asked, if you are able to answer, over. The problems related to the cards is very easy. Okay, now we will solve certain sums related to these cards now. I think it is clear, right? If you have some doubt, watch till here the video again and again and make your doubts clear. Okay, in the next section, we'll solve the sums related to this now. Okay, dear students, here is the first sum now. One card is drawn from a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards. Find the probability of getting. First one is a king of red color. So as we know, students, already there are 52 cards and even it is given in the sum. So possible outcomes, 52. Now, total number of red king cards we have to find out now. Students, already there are 13 spade cards are there and 13 black cards are there. And both these are black in color. So similarly like that, 13 diamond cards are there and 13 heart cards are there. And both these are in the red color. Now we have to find out a king of red color. So in every set of 13, there is a king, right? So it means totally 4 king cards are there. Now we need king of red color. So in the red color, how many kings are there? Only 2. It means total number of red king cards are just 2. Now probability of getting red king card, so that is P of E is equal to total number of outcomes we take every time in the denominator, and probability of the card which we have to find out is 2, so that we take into the numerator. If it is possible, divide them. Yes, of course it's possible here. 2 ones are, it's 2 twos are 4, 1 remains, 1 and 2 it's 12, so 2 6 are. So final answer is 1/26. This is the final answer, students. So here again you can see the answer is less than 1. So it means to solve the card related sums, this part is important. You have to know this thing properly. Then automatically you can find all the answers very easily, right? Okay, let's move to the next sum. Okay, students, the second sum now. We need to find this time a face card. Okay, first let the possible outcomes are, they are 52. Now total number of face cards. Okay, analyze again. 13 plus 13, these are black color cards, spade and club. Similarly again, 13 plus 13, these are red color cards, diamond and the heart. Now face cards, face cards in the sense, students, in every set of 13 card there are 3 face cards. One is jack, one is queen and one is the king. So Jack, queen and the king. So even here Jack, queen and the king. Similarly, Jack, queen, king, and again Jack, queen, king. So these are the face cards in every set of 13. Now check how many these are. So 3 into 4, so totally they are 12. Therefore total number of face cards are 12. The probability of getting a face card P of E is equal to total outcomes that must be in the denominator, and the probability of the part which we have to find, that is 12, take it in the numerator. If it is possible, divide these two. Okay, of course it is possible now, right? 4 3s are 12, 4 1s are 4, 1 remains 12, 4 3s are again, it means it is 3 by 13. So further we cannot divide. This is the final answer, and once again it is less than 1. So this is the probability of finding a face card, right? Okay, let's check one more sum. So this time students, we need to find a red face card. Okay, first you have to extract this number. Now before that, possible outcome of the cards is, it's 52. The total number of red face cards, okay, only red part will see now. 13 heart cards are there, 13 diamond cards are there. These are red in color. Here in 13 set, the face cards are, one is Jack, one is Queen, one is King. Similarly, Jack, Queen and the King. It means the face cards in the red color section, here 3 plus here 3. So in the diamond section 3, in the heart section 3 are there. So totally they are 6. So it means total number of red face cards are 6. Now again, the probability of getting red face cards, P of E is equal to total outcomes in the denominator and the total number of red face cards, that's in the numerator. Now both these are even numbers, so we can divide. 2 3s are 2 2s are 4, 1 remains 12, so the 12 comes in the 2 table, 6 are, so it's 3 by 26. Further we cannot divide. This is the final answer, right? So this is the probability of getting a red face card, that is 3 by 26. Okay, this is the third sum. Let's check one more sum in this. We have to find this time the Jack of hearts. Okay, first possible outcomes, they are 52. Now the total number of Jack of heart. Now okay, as we know there are 13 heart cards are there and they are red in color, right? So red color heart cards are there. So in that, how many Jack are there? It's only 1. In the sense, this number is just 1. Therefore probability of getting Jack hearts is P of E is equal to total outcomes 52, that's in the denominator. Jack of heart, it's one, just 1, so write it in the numerator. 1 by 52, further we cannot divide. This is the final answer. Don't you think students, these sums are so easy? But the condition is you must know how to analyze particular thing which is asked in the cards. So if you can analyze that one properly, then very easily you can substitute the values and you can find out the answers like this, the probabilities, right? Okay, under this section few more sums will check now. Okay, one card is drawn from a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards. Find the probability of getting this time a spade card. Okay, first possible outcomes, they are 52. Now the spade card we have to find. As you know students, there are 13 club cards are there, 13 spade cards are there, 13 heart cards are there and 13 diamond cards are there. So total comes to 52. Out of this, these two parts are black color, these two are nothing but red in color. Now a spade card is asked. Okay, spade card, it's not mentioned particularly a Jack of spade, a King of spade or something like that, just a spade card. In the sense, we have to select all this. So totally how many they are 13 cards. So total number of spade cards are 13. Let's substitute here. Therefore probability of getting spade card, that's P of E is equal to total outcomes 52 and total number of spade cards that's my numerator, that's 13. So if you can divide this, of course it is possible here. 13 ones are 13 fours are, so 1 by 4. This is the final answer. And as you can see, 1/4 of the cards are spelled cards. So even this is a very easy sum. Condition again the same. You must know this part. Okay, under this section, students, we'll solve one last sum. No? After that, some homework is there for you. And if you do that homework, this part will be very clear for you. And even in the exam, you can solve sums related to this very easily. Okay, let's check that last sum now. One card is drawn from a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards. Find the probability of hitting the queen diamond. Okay, this time we have to find probability of queen diamond. First, possible outcomes, they are 52. Now, total number of queen of diamond card. Okay, as you know, students, again, if you analyze, 13 hard cards are there, 13 diamond cards are there, 13 spade cards, 13 club cards. So only diamond section we have to concentrate now. In a diamond section, how many queen cards are there? We know there is one ace card, there is one jack, queen and king. It means only one queen card is there. So total number of queens of the diamond cards are nothing but just 1. Therefore, probability of getting a queen of diamond card, that's P of E, is equal to total number in the denominator, queen of card, that's in the numerator. So this is the final answer. So these sums are very, very easy sums, students. Only the thing, you must know thoroughly the different types of cards present in the deck of 52 cards. Okay, if you know that part clearly, then automatically you can solve these sums very easily. Okay, now to make you more perfect related to these type of sums, we have some homework for you now. Great, students, here is the homework part. Again, one card is drawn from a well shuffled deck of 52 cards. Find the probability of hitting. Okay, the first note of that is a king of black card. So in the black color cards, how many king cards are there? Extract that number and find out this answer. Then comes a diamond card. It's just like that what we solved, spade card, right? Just like that it is. Next is asked a C sum. It's a black card. So totally out of 52 cards, how many black color cards are there? Take that number and divide that into the number by 52. Okay, easily you will get the answers. Okay, send these answers in the comment section. I'll be waiting for your answers, and do not forget to practice these sums, students. With this update, we'll end the video here only. Okay, these are the sums which are very important in the probability section. With the next video, we'll be starting with one more new topic. Okay, what will be that topic? Wait and watch in the next video. And if you want to see what is that topic, then definitely you have to subscribe the channel, press the bell icon, share these videos as much as you can with your friends, like the videos, do not forget that part. You will meet once again in the next one more 100% question. Till then, study well, study hard.